tea's ready. That's what's going to push me down the river. It's 5:30 in the morning. It's supposed to be sunny this morning and then rain this evening, so I should have quite a nice drift down the tide, down the channel here, down the ooze. Looks to me as though there's a nice mist on the river, so I'm going to, as soon as the kettle's boiled, I'm going to set off. It's been a nice trip, very good. Rough old night though. I'm in no rush, so I might as well just enjoy the journey rather than have the engine going. And the river looks beautiful and sounds fantastic. I'm having to do about 2 strokes of the paddle every 5 minutes just to keep myself in the middle of the flow. It's not running that fast at the moment. I'm sure later on I will have to put the engine on just to keep control. 3 meters underneath me. Starting to burn up already. Some trees heading my way. Paddle. Blackbirds are giving it. There you are. Two and a half meters underneath me, so 7 foot should be more than enough for any boat. And the current's taking me along at about 1.6 knots. I'm not having to paddle much. People have criticized me for doing this. Got the life jacket on underneath here. But this is really loose at the top. When you see the life jackets burst, they burst out of the top there and a bit here, and I can get it off in no time. If I had to put the life jacket on over the top of this jacket every time, it wouldn't be very good. There are some beautiful houses along this river. This place here is a cracker. Really looks like it should be haunted though. Just imagine living there in the summer. Colder and buggery in the winter. Thank you.
slacken to 1.2 knots. Quite
nice. Morning. Morning. Isn't it fabulous?
Drifting more than sailing, but still, at least this gives me the power to put the boat in the right bit of the river. There's not much wind at all, just enough to keep the bow pointing in the right direction. Disappears every now and again. An old topper sail. Did 2.1 knot, perfectly respectable. 4 meters. So anybody with any sort of keel could get up here, get a centaur up here, no problems. They have a very nice week on a centaur up here, you have to leave the mast down. I really like the way, when the tide turns, the current's running, you get all these little sparkles underneath the trees, beautiful. Two point two knots now. Starting to pick up pretty fast. Wow, I thought I was going to have to be motoring all day.
worries if it's wood until they break. Worry, 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 worry. Quite a lot of those. There's a name for them. Wobbling bits of wood.
I'm in a bit of a dilemma because I don't know, I don't want to start pumping the tide when I get to the other end. I don't want to get down to the bottom after the tide has turned, otherwise I'm going to have to try and beat the tide up. As the tide comes up the Humber, I'm going to be going down it. But I don't want to stop sailing.
Maximum speed, 7.7 knots, moving average, 17 hours moving, plus what I did the other side of the lock. So, 17 hours, it's not massive, is it?